And you mean to say that after you'd done this wonderful thing for them without making a single mistake, that they just sat there and never said a word to you? Never petted you or admired you or told you how splendid you'd be?
Not a word.
Well, it's simply appalling. I should not have thrown the slippers at him. I should have thrown the fire irons.
Mama! Mama!
I thought it wouldn't be long. Just stay where you are, my dear. Stay where you are.
Mother Devil, where the devil could you be?
Remember last night, you not only danced with a prince, you behaved like a princess.
Mother, the damnedest thing happened. I can't find... you!
Good afternoon, Professor Higgins. Are you quite well?
Am I?
No, but of course you are. You are never ill. Would you care for some tea?
Don't you play the game with me. I taught it to you. Now get up and come home and don't be a fool. You've already caused me enough trouble for the morning.
Oh, very well put indeed, Henry. No woman could resist such an invitation.
How did this baggage get here in the first place?
Eliza came to see me, and I was delighted to have her. And if you cannot promise to behave yourself, I shall have to ask you to leave.
You want me to put my Sunday manners on for this thing I created out of squashed cabbage leaves of Covent Garden?
Yes, that is precisely what I mean.
I'll see a damn first.
Ever learn manners with my son around?
It was rather difficult. I should never have known how ladies and gentlemen behave had it not been for Colonel Pickering. He always showed me that he felt and thought of me as more than just a common flower girl. You see, Mrs. Higgins, besides what one may pick up, the difference between a lady and a flower girl is not how she behaves, but how she is treated. I shall always be a flower girl to Professor Higgins because he has always treated me as such and always will. But I shall always be a lady to Colonel Pickering because he has always treated me as a lady and always will.
Henry, don't grind your teeth.
The vicar is here, madam. Shall I show him to the garden?
The vicar? And the professor, good heavens, no. I shall see him in the library. Eliza, if my son begins to break things, I give you full permission to have him evicted. And Henry, dear, if I were you, I should stick to two subjects.
The weather and your health.
Well, Eliza, I see you've got a bit of your back, as you call it. Have you had enough? Are you going to be reasonable, or do you want any more?
You only want me back so that I may pick up your slippers and fetch and carry feet.
I never said I wanted you back at all.
Oh, indeed. Then what is it we are talking about?
About you, not me. Look, if you come back home, I will treat you the same way as I have always treated you. I can't change my manners, and I certainly can't change my nature. My manners are the same as Colonel Pickering's.
That's not true. He treats a flower girl as if she were a duchess.
And I treat a duchess as if she was a flower girl.
Oh, I see, the same for everybody.
Just so. The great secret, Eliza, is not about having good manners or bad manners or any particular sort of manners. It's about having the same manners for each human soul. The question is not whether I treated you rudely, but whether I treated anyone else better.
Oh, I don't care how you treat me. I don't mind your swearing at me. I wouldn't mind a black eye. I've had one before. But I won't be passed over.
And so you move out of the way. You treat me like I'm a motor bus.
So you are a motor bus. I'll bounce and go with no regard for anyone else. But I can get along without you. Don't think I can't.
I know you can't. I told you you could. I suppose you never wondered whether or not I could get along without you.
Oh, don't try and get around me. You'll have to.
And so I will. And I shall miss you, Eliza. I've learned something from your idiotic notions. I confess, humbly and gratefully.
You have my voice on your gramophone. When you grow lonely without me, you may turn it on. It has no feelings to hurt.
I can't turn your soul on.
Oh, you are a devil. You can twist the heart in a girl as easily as somebody twists her arm to hurt her. But what am I to come back for?
For the fun of it. That's why I took you on.
And you may throw me out tomorrow when I don't do everything you ask.
Yes. And you may walk out if I don't do everything you want me to.
And live with my father.
Yes, or sell flowers. Ugh. Or you could marry Pickering.
I wouldn't marry you if you asked me, and you're closer to my age than what he is.
And he is.
Speak as I like. You're not my teacher now. No, that's not what I want from you, and don't you think it. Why, I've always had gentlemen wanting that way. Why, Freddie Hill writes me twice and three times daily, sheets and sheets.
Is that it? You want me to be as infatuated as he is with you?
No, that's not the sort of feeling that I want from you. I want a little bit of kindness. Why, I know I'm just a common ignorant girl and you a book-learned gentleman, but I am not dirt under your feet. What I did, was not for the clothes or the taxis, but because we were rather pleasant together. And I came to care for you. Not wanting you to make love to me and not forgetting the difference between us, but something more friendly like.
Yes, of course, that's how I feel. That's how Pickering feels. Eliza, you are a fool!
Oh, that's not a proper answer to give me!
Well, that's the only answer you're gonna get until you stop being a plain idiot! Eliza, if you want to be a lady, then you have got to stop feeling neglected. Every time the men you know don't spend half their time sniveling over you, and the other half giving you black eyes. Oh. So you find me cruel, selfish, unkind, and fine. Be with the sort of people that you like. Go find some other sentimental hog with lots of money and a big pair of lips to kiss you with and a big pair of black boots to kick you with. If you can't appreciate what you've got, then you better just get what you can appreciate.
Oh, I can't talk to you. You turn everything against me. I'm always in the wrong. But don't you be so sure that you have me under your feet to be trampled on. I'll marry Fred here, Will. As soon as I'm able to support us.
Marry Freddy? That poor devil who couldn't get a job as an errand boy even if he tried? Woman, do not understand. I made you a consort for a king!
Freddy loves me! That makes him king enough for me! Why, I wouldn't expect him to work. He wasn't brought up to it as I was, but I'll go and be a teacher.
And what in heaven's name are you going to teach?
I'll teach what you taught me. I'll teach phonetics. I'll offer myself as an assistant to that brilliant Hungarian.
What? That imposter, that humbug, that toadiest ignoramus! Teach him my methods, discovers you go anywhere near that area, and I will just wring your neck.
Ring away! What do I care? I always knew you'd strike me one day anyhow. Ah, that's done you, has it, Henry Higgins? Well, I don't care for your bullying and your big talk. What a fool I was! What a dominated fool! To think you were the earth and sky! What a fool I was! What an addle-pated fool! What a mutton-headed dolt was I! No, my reverberating friend, you are not the beginning and the end!
There isn't a word of thought in that brain that I haven't put in there!
There'll be spring every year without you. England still will be here without you. There'll be fruit on the tree and a shore by the sea. There'll be crumpets and tea without you. Art and music will thrive without you. Somehow Keats will survive without you. And there still will be Reno, that plain land in Spain. Even that will remain without you. I can do without you, you dear friend who talk so well. You can go to Hartford, Hereford, and Hampshire. They will still rule the land without you. Windsor Castle can stand without you. So without much ado, we will all muddle through without you. Comes in without your twirling it, the earth can spin. Without your pushing them, the clouds roll by. If they can do without you, ducky, so can I. I will not be alone without you. I can stand on my own without you. So go back in your shell. I can do bloody well without.
I don't. I did it. I said I'd make a woman, and indeed I did. I knew it. I knew I could do it and succeed. I did. Eliza, you're magnificent. 5 minutes ago, you were a millstone around my neck. Now you're a tower of strength, a consort battleship. I like you like this.
Goodbye, Professor Higgins. You shall not be seeing me again!
Mother? Mother!
What is it, Henry? What has happened?
She's gone!
Well, of course, dear. What did you expect?
Well, what am I supposed to do?
Do without, I suppose.
And so I shall. And so I can. If the Higgins oxygen burns up her little lungs, then may she find some other stuffiness that suits her. Caesar, sickened owl, sickened by a few days of my sunshine. But very well, I don't need her, I don't need anyone. I have my own divine spark of fire.
Bravo, Eliza.
Grown accustomed to her face. She almost makes the day begin. I've grown accustomed to the tune. She whistles night and noon. Her smiles, her frowns, her ruffs, her gowns are second nature to me now. I keep breathing out and breathing in. Was serenely independent and content before we met. surely I could always be that way again. And yet, I've grown accustomed to a voice, accustomed to a look, accustomed to a face. Mary Frey, what an infantile idea. What a heartless, reckless, brainless thing to do. But she'll regret it. She'll regret it. It's doomed before they even take the vow. How poignant will it be on that inevitable night when she hammers on my door in tears and rags, lonely and contrite. Will I let her in or throw her to the wolves? Will I take her back or give her the treatment she deserves? Do I give her kindness or do I throw the baggage out? I'm a most forgiving man. A sort who never could, ever would, take a position and staunchly never budge. Just a most forgiving man. But I shall never take her back. If she were crawling on her knees, let her shiver, let her moan, let her promise to atone, I will slam the door and let the hellcat breathe. Mary Frey.
I washed my face and hands before I come, I did.
Eliza. Where the devil are my slippers?